Welcome to episode 13 of Behind the Shield. Today we talk to senior field hockey player Dana Meehling. Hello again, everybody. Scott Geist back with another edition of Behind the Shield. Very excited to get to talk to Dana today. We're going to talk about the trip to Spain that the team took before COVID-19 struck. We're going to talk about the upcoming campaign in 2020. And we're also going to talk about how the team's been able to stay in contact during this strange time that we're all living through with COVID-19. So after this commercial break, Dana Meehling.
The results are in, and it's clear that our Spartan family really showed their love for York College this YCP Day of Giving. You played an integral role in helping us reach new heights. Thank you for your generosity. Gifts from donors like you make a difference in the lives of our students every single day. Your continued support is so important. Because YCP is a nonprofit, so much of the York College experience is a direct result of the generosity of our donors. This year's Day of Giving created opportunities for every current and future student by providing funding for scholarships, academic areas, and student life that tuition alone cannot cover. Thank you to the entire Spartan family. Alumni, current students, parents, and friends of the college. We couldn't have done it without you.
Welcome back to episode 13 of Behind the Shield. Today, Dana Meehling is with us. Dana, thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
So we get to ask everybody, open up, how's quarantine been? Obviously, you survived school the spring semester. How are you doing?
All right. Just like keeping myself busy, doing workouts, preparing for like the next 2 months ahead before season. So just, you know, doing what I can to keep myself like sane in the mind.
I can't believe you're going to be a senior this year. First of all, that's crazy to me. It's amazing how fast 4 years goes by. But you know, hopefully before you know, you will be back on campus and we'll be getting going. So I want to start out and talk about your trip to Spain. Obviously, fortunately for you guys, you were able to get that in before the whole COVID-19 thing hit and you were able to go overseas. Talk a little bit about that trip and what it was like for you guys to go as a team.
Yeah, so like you said, we got extremely lucky in going before all of this came to the U.S. and we were fortunately able to get back to the U.S. safely. But it was just an amazing experience as like just traveling and also field hockey. We got to explore like two different cities, Madrid and Barcelona, and just being like together as a team, learning about like the history of like the country and also just like their culture and all the different types of food we got to eat was amazing. And then also like the field hockey aspect of it, we got to play three different teams of like three different levels, and then we were also able to have three training sessions with international coaches. So we got to learn like a lot of new skills and also refine our some skills that we already did know, but also learn like maybe different techniques of how to do those. So it was just a great overall experience in both the travel part, but also the field hockey part.
How much fun was it for you guys to be together in a travel situation like that as a team? Was the team bonding great? Was it something that you guys really enjoyed getting to spend that kind of time together?
Yeah, like I know we all like love spending time together like at school and everything, but we're not always together like 24/7. So during that week, we were together every single second, every single minute. Like, so it was just like a great way to maybe get to know somebody on a different level while we were over there, just because you were together all the time, or you may be rooming with somebody different than you've never really lived with before. But yeah, it was just like a great bonding experience that you might not usually get to experience with your team.
So how have you guys been keeping in touch? You know, we talked to Coach Foss yesterday and, you know, she kind of went through some of the things she's doing. How are you guys able to keep in touch during this time? Because you essentially go from a trip where you're together all the time to, you know, a week and a half later, dispersing and kind of going your separate ways.
So we, like she said, we had like our spring season, which we were fortunately able to do virtually. And we were able to meet, I think it was like four times a week. And we would do like small group things, like with our attacking and defensive groups. And then also like workout sessions we could do. But other than that, it's just been, we have like our group chats like with our whole team. And we also have like a Snapchat group chat that we might just send like random things in, like, oh yeah, like Sam calls, she had like a lizard. So she was like, I just got a lizard today, or just something like simple like that, or just like texting each other, or we actually see each other every 2 weeks on Zoom because we meet with Isaiah now, and he goes over like our training for like those following 2 weeks. So we get to see each other, and we might stay on for an extra 20 minutes after, just like talking and catching up. And also just trying to get like our freshmen involved as well, because we will be entering into the season soon, or in 2 months, but just like trying to encourage everybody to stay active and just trying to talk to anybody whenever, just to give them a little more encouragement.
You talked about staying connected. How important is that going to be? How do you believe that will play out once we get back together and we're on the field? Is it kind of like, well, do you think it'll allow you to kind of hit the ground running, so to speak, once you get back?
I definitely think it does help. Like for our, like us returners, like we will always have like a connection. But definitely for the freshmen, just trying to bring them in, because when I was a freshman, when Katie had been hired like 2 or 3 days before season, I was probably with the team maybe like twice before that. And I didn't even know like my whole class coming in. I knew probably two of them. So it was just kind of like, I don't really know what's going on. And like I was like really nervous as a person, like just going in there, but the way Katie's doing it now and like how our whole team is just trying to get everybody involved, I think it will really help not only the freshmen, but us entire, like as a group, to not, like I said, hit the ground running, but definitely have one step further than coming in and being like, I don't know these people. But I definitely do think it'll help us get going quicker when we do get on campus.
So you talked about coming in, you know, you were among the freshmen that, and I can't believe Coach has been here 4 years either. It flies by. But I remember those 2 days, 2 days before the preseason starts, you know, our new head coach rolls into town. How much has changed over the course of time from your freshman year until now? Talk about some of the things that she's been able to accomplish in terms of culture. You know, I know, you know, that's one of the big things for her is culture and team unity and all that stuff. What has, in your mind, changed over the last 3.5 years?
Yeah, so when, like, obviously, like we said, when she came in, like, she didn't even know us. Like, it was just kind of like, I got to get the team going somehow during preseason, like, just start practices and then get to know them. And as, like, through the years, like, I definitely have seen a change in how she's been laying the foundation of, like, what she wants her culture to be for her program. And that was really in like the first, I would say like my first 2 years, and same with her. And then once we like laid that foundation, I feel like it has become not only her like preaching it to us maybe, but like not only her saying it and like wanting us to do it. Now it's like our team right now, we actually like show the culture in how we act and how we act during like in games or on the field or in the classroom or just as a person in general. So like, watching it go through where she was trying to figure out what she wanted to do with all of like with her culture, and then her figuring it out, and then now it's actually being shown not only by her but like us as players as well.
How important is it, the relationship that she has with the group and then that she has with you individually? It was funny at some point in the time in the interview the other day, you could tell she's so passionate about it that she started to get a little emotional. But how is that important, and why does that work for not only as a team, but in her individual relationships with players?
So for her, I hate saying this, and like, I feel like it's so kind of weird to say, but like, and I've always said this, like, she is like our second mom at campus, like not in a bad way at all. Like, she just cares about all of us. So like genuinely, and it's like so real that she just wants us to be able to like communicate with her either as a group, like if we're struggling as a group and we need to go to her and be like, hey, like we need some help, or like we don't really know what to do, like we can go to her. It's like a completely open and honest relationship that she wants to know how we are feeling. And that's as a group and as a person. Like, I know I've gone into her office sometimes and I'm like, I am having a completely awful day. And I have just cried to her. Like, it just happens. And like, she just like wants to be there for you so that she can trust you and I can trust her. And not only like us doing that for her and her doing it for us, like she puts in so much effort for like our relationships, and that could be on and off the field. Like, if she's putting in her effort, obviously like we want to give it back to her as well.
And does that, do you find that that kind of in effect snowballs? Because now as a senior, you kind of pass that down. And obviously, you know, we have a large sophomore class this year who have been through it for a year and now they understand what the program's about. Does it just kind of continue to get better and better because everybody just sees it and buys into what you're trying to do?
Yeah, definitely. I think that, like, because, I mean, I guess when she came in as, like, our coach, and none of us really knew her, and like she said in the last episode, how like all the other coaches, it was like one was here and then they left, and then another one was here and then they left. Mm-hmm. So she's actually had time to like build those relationships up throughout the years, and then as like you said, it does snowball. Like, I think underclassmen see it and then they can be like, yeah, I can go to her, I can, or even ask an upperclassman, hey, like, can I either say this for you and then can you go tell her, or would this be okay to go to talk to coach about? And then they just know that like they can talk to her and she will listen and be there for them.
Well, and I think two things that come to my mind when you talk about this is trust and honesty. And those are the two, you know, I think any team that's great, you have to have trust, honesty, and I think love is part of that too. How important are those as part of your program?
Yeah, they're very important. Obviously, you want to trust your, like, your coaches and your teammates. Like, if I'm going to do something, I need them to do it for me too. And if you're going to do that, like, obviously you have to be honest about it. Like, if they're going to be telling you something, like, I want to know the truth and nothing but the truth. And like, everything just goes, like, I think that all snowballs together too. Like, you can't have trust without honesty. Like, they all go together. And same with love. Like, if I'm going to put all my trust into you, like, I expect you to tell me the truth and be honest. And then, like, once you get that developed, like, you wouldn't feel anything other than love for that person and be like, yes, this is what I feel for you. And, like, I'm going to care about you because I know that you trust me and can be honest. And I hope you do the same for me.
Man, I'm getting really excited for the season. Let's go. Let's get ready to go. I want to ask you, what are some of the things you love about being a York College Spartan, especially a field hockey player? What are some of the things that the program has done for you and that you really appreciate being a member of the team?
So, like, when I first came in as a freshman, like I said, like, I had only been with the team a couple times, maybe like two or three, but everybody was just so welcoming. They were always just like, you should come hang out with us, like. And that's, like, one thing that's always been so constant throughout my 3 years, and I'm hoping it for to be the fourth, but is that we're always, like, all together and so friendly. Like, obviously, like, we might have a little things here and there, but we're always so close, and, like, you can go to somebody. Like, there's always somebody on the team that you can be like, hey, I might, like, I need help. And that might just be, like, a real-world situation, or, like, you want to come help me on the field with a skill, or anything like that. But like, we're always all there for each other and just care about each other as like a person and a player.
So your recruiting process is probably a little different than other people. Obviously, Melissa played lacrosse for us, and how much of that experience of getting and coming and watching her play, even though it's a different sport, how much did that influence you in terms of coming to York and wanting to be a part of the athletic department?
So obviously, like, when Melissa came to York, I had been to the campus many times before. Like, I had contacted what would have been Carly. She was the one who actually recruited me, and then it just kind of, like, went up through the coaches. But just, like, being able to be on campus, like, I would come and see Melissa, and then I might just run into the coach and be like, hey, like, and then they'd be like, how are you doing? And just, like, talking to them. But it really, like, made a good impact on me because I did see how, like, I always saw how, like, different sports were coming to support the lacrosse team, or like I would see the field hockey team going out for spring practice after my sister's game. So it's like I just saw like how all the different athletic teams were meshing as like one big athletic department, which was really cool. And really like showed me like this is such like, even though it's like a smaller school, like you still have so many different friends from like everywhere, like throughout campus.
I think that's one of the things that we are really lucky to have. We have great culture. You know, it goes from the student athletes who are together. You guys are always supporting each other, which is awesome. To our coaches, all really enjoy getting along. I honestly, that's been the hardest thing for me is not seeing our coaches. You know, when I normally would, obviously I miss our kids a ton too, but I think you hit on it with the culture thing. So let's look forward to next year or this year, 2 months ahead. Moving to the MAC, what are some of the things that you're excited about in terms of moving conferences?
So I don't really know much about any of the teams. Like I think Stevenson, we've played, mm-hmm. like we played them before, but I don't really know too many.
Albright, Messiah too.
Yeah. So like we've played a couple of them, but it's also kind of fun not knowing who you're going to be playing. And like, obviously you never know, like every team is different every single year. So it's just like fun being able to go play different teams. And like we have that automatic qualifier now. So I think that's like a really good chance for us to get into the national tournament as well. So, and that's obviously everybody's goal for the season is like to get to the postseason. And, but yeah, just like moving, like I know we always played like really great teams, but now I think we're going to have a really good chance to play a lot of other teams as well that are still going to be just as good. And just being able to compete with all different teams and a lot closer drives.
There you go. The travel, that is always something that comes up. All right. If we're having a conversation in mid-November, and you get a chance to look back, what are you hoping that this year, what are you hoping the story of the 2020 field hockey season will be?
I mean, you always hope for the best, but all I want from like this coming season is that everybody just puts their best effort into every single second of every game. Like knowing that maybe you didn't get the result you wanted, you still know that even though you did put all your effort, there's nothing more you could do. Like, and that goes into every game and every practice and this time during the summer. Like you have to prepare for what you want to be your result in the season. So just really knowing that everybody did their part to do what we should do during our season, I think that's all. Obviously, like, I want, no matter what the result is. Obviously, if we get to a national championship and win, we did all the work that we should have. Yeah.
And I think if you take care of the work, the results take care of themselves a lot of times. I think that's definitely true. So, well, thank you so much for joining us. It was great to catch up with you. Enjoy what's left of your summer. I say what's left. Heck, we got 2.5 months. It just feels like we've been on summer break for so long. But take care of yourself and stay healthy and stay busy, and we'll see you, you know, hopefully around August, middle of August, and you know, hopefully we'll be as close to back to normal as we possibly can. So thanks a lot, Dana.
Thank you.
At your college, we are proud of the fact that we have over 30 cultures and 30 countries represented among our campus community. We not only are proud of that fact, we celebrate the unique perspective and differences that each and every person on this campus brings to us. So on behalf of all of us at York College, I want you to know that you are welcome here.
Tu eres bienvenido aquí. Vous êtes bien reçu ici. You're very welcome here.
You are welcome here.
You are welcome here.
Você está bem-vindo aqui.
You are welcome here.
You are welcome here.
You are welcome here.
You're welcome here.
معكم رقية آل الشيخ من كلية يورك في بنسلفانيا. أنتم مرحب بكم هنا. We are welcome.
From day one at York College of Pennsylvania,
you are welcome here.
We want to thank Dana Meehling for joining us today. Certainly great to catch up with her, and we really look forward to seeing her on the field along with her Spartan teammates. A lot of great things happening in that field hockey program. Can't wait to see how they perform on the field in 2020. So that's the episode for this week. We'd like to thank you for joining us as always. And please stay safe, stay healthy, and go Spartans.